Yes, absolutely.
For whatever reason.
So what happened, Jada?
Okay, so let's start with, I guess about 4.5 years ago.
Yeah,
started a, I think it was about 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Started a friendship with August.
Mm-hmm.
And we actually became really, really good friends.
Mm-hmm.
And it all started with him just needing some help.
Mm-hmm.
You know, me wanting to help his health, his mental state.
Because for me, that was the thing. When Aug first came around, he was
really,
really sick.
He was really, really sick, yeah.
And the outpouring for him from our family was initially about his health.
Yeah. And I mean, we found all those different resources, mm-hmm. To help pull him through.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, you and I were going through a very difficult time.
Yeah.
And we decided.
I was done with your ass.
Yeah, you kicked me to the curb.
I was done with you.
Yeah.
Marriages have that, though.
Yeah,
marriages have that.
Yeah, we basically, mm-hmm. we broke up.
We decided that we were going to separate for a period of time, and you go figure out how to make yourself happy, and I'll figure out how to make myself happy.
Well, at that particular point in time, it was indefinite.
Yeah, I really felt like we could be over.
We were over.
And then what did you do, Jada?
Well, I think from there, as time went on, I got into a different kind of entanglement
mm-hmm.
with August. And one thing I want to get clear about and clean up, one of the things that was kind of swirling in the press about you giving permission, mm-hmm. which is, the only person that could give permission in that particular circumstance is myself.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. But what August was probably trying to communicate,
mm-hmm.
because I could actually see how he would perceive it as permission because we were separated mm-hmm. amicably.
Yeah.
And I think he also wanted to make it clear that he's not a homewrecker,
mm-hmm.
which he's not.
I think so. I mean, because this is your red table and you like brought yourself to the red table. I think you need to say clearly what happened.
As far as what?
You and I decided we were going to take our space and what happened.
Yeah. And then I got into an entanglement with August. That's what I said.
An entanglement?
Yes. Yes.
A relationship.
Yes. It was a relationship. Absolutely. I was in a lot of pain. And I was very broken. Now, in the process of that relationship, I definitely realized that you can't find happiness outside of yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And luckily enough, you and I were also going through a process of healing in a much different manner. Mm-hmm. I would definitely say we did everything that we could to get away from each other, only mm-hmm. to realize that that mm-hmm. wasn't possible.
So we come to the red table. So I'm in the Jada position right now. So,
okay.
You during that time launched into an interaction
mm-hmm.
with August. What do you feel like you were looking for?
I just wanted to feel good.
Mm-hmm.
It had been so long
mm-hmm.
since I felt good.
Yeah.
And it was really a joy to just help heal somebody.
Yeah.
I think that has a lot to do with my codependency, which is another thing that I had to learn to break in this cycle. Just mm-hmm. that idea of needing to fix and being drawn to people that need help, whether it's your health or whether it's your addictions.
Mm-hmm.
There's something about that childhood trauma
mm-hmm.
That feels as though it can be fixed through fixing people
mm-hmm.
versus fixing me.
Yeah.
And I think that that whole process with Aug really showed me that
mm-hmm.
and taught me that. And I'm really grateful for that lesson.
I feel like that husband, like I'm with you at the press conference. I'm that husband. Now I got to be with you at the press conference while you tell the world about your transgressions.
Well,
Like, I love my baby. I'm going to stand by my baby no matter what.
Well, you know, I definitely understand why it would look that way or feel that way. But I actually don't look at it as a transgression at all. Through that particular journey, I learned so much about myself and was able to really confront a lot of emotional immaturity, emotional insecurity. Mm-hmm. And I was really able to do some really deep healing, you know. And as I came through and started to realize certain things about you and I, he decided to break all communication with me,
right,
which was totally understandable.
Right.
And I let that be and hadn't talked to him since.
Right.
So it is a little weird that all this stuff is coming out now since this was.
Yeah, because for me, this was years ago, right? You know, so the fact that it's coming up now, and I think it could feel weird for people that we're laughing and talking about it, but
it happened so long ago.
You know, and our experiences of working through it, fighting through it, talking through it, and therapizing through it. I think that the why now is weird.
Yeah. When I say it's been a huge healing on my life and just what I had to confront and discover, you know, about myself, the ugly truths and the beauty. Mm-hmm. So it was something that I felt like wasn't really ready to be discussed because it hadn't been that healing, because he hasn't wanted to, you know, Aug and I haven't talked in so long, you know what I mean? So I don't know, this all seemed very strange, you know, but I'm grateful for the journey that you and I have had together, because I feel like there are a lot of couples that go through those periods and a lot of couples that have to separate and think it's over and, you know. The one thing I'll say about you and I is that there's never been secrets.
Right. We came together young, and we were both broken in our own ways. And to be able to make mistakes without the fear of losing your family is so critical.
Yeah. It's the idea of any relationship. And trying to get to deeper understanding of love is going to be forged in fire.
Yeah.
There's no way around it.
Yeah.
And I think that one of the things that I'm deeply grateful in this whole process between you and I is that we have really gotten to that new place of unconditional love.
Because I wasn't sure I was ever going to speak to you again.
I know.
Yeah, like, the fact that I'm speaking to you again is a miracle.
I would agree.
No, but it ain't for the weak at heart. There's just certain things that you have to go through, and it's like.
And I wish, you know, I wish that wasn't the case. I do.
I sure wish it could be all magic and miracles.
Yeah. You got to go through some to get the answers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'm just happy because I definitely believe that you and I, we never, ever, ever thought that we would make it back.
Yeah, there's a real power in the just knowing somebody's riding with you no matter what.
Yeah.
And you really can't know that
until you go through
some stuff, you know. I don't want to go through this no more.
Yeah, no, I don't either.
Yeah. I'm going to get you back first. And then
you're going to get me back. I think you've got me back. I think we're good on that. Okay.
Okay. That's probably true.
And I don't think it's about getting anybody back.
No, for me it is.
Okay. I'll give you that petty. If that's what you want. but you know, I will definitely say it's just part of it.
Yeah.
You know, if you expect to be with somebody for a lifetime.
25 years and counting.
We ride together.
We die together.
Bad marriage for life.
That's terrible.
It's the truth.
It's the truth.
But yeah, it's just part of the journey.
I told you the first year we were married.
What'd you tell me?
That I can love you through anything.
And I didn't believe you.
Yeah.
If somebody looked through a crystal ball and said, this, 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 and this is going to happen, I'd be like, mm-hmm. no way.
Yeah.